How powerful is Gojo? I bet you didn't see this coming, guys, huh? Well, yeah, as the title indicates, today we will be theorizing about a different anime, and that is Jujutsu Kaisen. I only watched like 5 episodes and I haven't read the manga yet. But wait, hey guys, let me tell you the story on how I discovered this anime. So it's true that a lot of people are talking about it, but I didn't give it that much of attention yet. But one day I saw this fight, Gojo versus Sukuna. And guys, what a moment that was. I was immediately astonished, fascinated by the animation and the story. Keep in mind, guys, that the only thing I knew when I watched that video of Gojo versus Sukuna was the name of Jujutsu Kaisen. The moment the fight began, I fell in love by the animation and how the fight sequence unfolded. I actually paused that video. And I was like, no, I need to watch the full episodes now. So as I told you guys, I haven't read the manga. I will, but for now I don't want to, because there is like a beautiful feeling watching an anime and not knowing what's gonna happen, like getting surprised by what's actually going on. So please guys, don't spoil anything in the comments. Alright, so our topic today is Gojo. How powerful is he? The first time he appeared was in episode number 2. Well, he was talking on the phone with Megumi in episode number 1, but I'm talking about his physical appearance. Gojo appeared in a very critical time, like Megumi wasn't sure what he is going to do with Itadori after like he swallowed the finger. He thought that he was like being played. So Gojo shows up, he tells his student, "I wasn't planning on coming, but you sure look roughed up." He immediately whips his phone and starts teasing Megumi, taking picture of him so he can show it to the second year student on how beaten he was. He asks him if he had any luck finding Ryuman Sukuna's finger. Itadori and Megumi replies on the same time, he did actually ate it. So Gojo closes the distance with Itadori and keep inspecting him up close. He laughs and tells him, "You really did merge with the curse." I kinda knew that he was very powerful, like the way he acts and how carefree he is despite the appearance of a special grade curse. So Gojo actually asks Itadori to switch with Sukuna for 10 seconds, and this is like the last thing you want Itadori to do, like right there. The latter reluctantly agrees and tells him, but Gojo replies, "Don't worry, I am the strongest." He tells Megumi to hold on to his package while he prepares to face off against Sukuna. Like he kept talking to his student about the food and the types until Sukuna jumped and attacked Gojo. The next thing you see, Gojo sitting on Sukuna. We do know how powerful this curse is, and like he kept explaining the flavors like he doesn't care about him, you know. His personality is really fascinating, and that's what really got me in watching the anime in the first place. Gojo reveals insane speed and reflexes as he was able to avoid the attacks of Sukuna like they were nothing, in mere seconds. He then stops and tells the curse that his student is watching, so he is going to show a bit. And oh my god, the animation of that scene. MAPPA really did an astounding job with Jujutsu Kaisen, and I think that a lot of fans are really more than satisfied with the overall animation. Sukuna comments that he is unbelievably fast. And then he said, "No, that's not it." Alright, right there, that scene got brushed off like it was nothing, but I think this is an important piece of the puzzle on how strong is Gojo. He also did the clap thing and crossed his fingers before the fight. I think that is some kind of technique that allows him to see into the future, or like to read the opponent's attacks or something like that. Like I told you guys, I only theorizing of 5 episodes and the manga is not included. So the fights carry on and Sukuna gets thrown back by a powerful punch from Gojo. The curse later commands that whatever era, Jujutsu sorcerers are always troubled. Sukuna follows by a very powerful punch, but it did absolutely nothing. Even Ryuman seems very shocked at the sight of Gojo unharmed. So Gojo kept counting as Itadori reverted back to his human form, I guess. This fight actually makes me wonder if there is any character within the world of Jujutsu Kaisen that it is stronger than Gojo himself. He seems like he maxed all his skills, abilities, and he's just there for the fun of it. So on the way to the Tokyo Metropolitan Jujutsu Technical High School, Sukuna asks Gojo, "So you're not the boss here?" Tsukune emerges again from the backhand of Itadori and tells Gojo that he will be the first one to kill after acquiring this body. Gojo replies that it is an honor to be targeted by Sukuna Ryumon. Now this is where things get interesting. After a quick background on Sukuna as the king of curses, Itadori asks Gojo who's stronger, you or him. Gojo replies and tells him this, if Sukuna regained all his powers, it might be a little draining. Like what? Guys, you saw one finger, what is capable of doing. Like imagine Itadori absorbing 20 fingers. The power is immeasurable. This is what he said. He said it could be a little draining. I'm not sure what he exactly meant by that. Maybe he's going to use one of his strongest techniques to kill the king of curses, or maybe like seal him away. Itadori asks, would you lose? Gojo replies confidently, I'd win. What I really like about this Gojo character is his personality and how he handles things. Like, yeah, if the most powerful curses appears, although it might be draining, I'd win. Another testament on how powerful Gojo is revealed in episode 5 of Jujutsu Kaisen. While he was in the morgue talking with an executive, Ishichitsa, he mentioned that he did suggest the suspension of the execution of Sukuna / Itadori. Of course, the higher ups, as he indicated, didn't like that. He said, when I was away, they did find a way to tactically dispose of him, facing off against a special grade, and it is the Womb Curse, despite the fact that he is only a first year. Iyuchi tells him that they didn't know it was a special grade by the time they get there. But guys, if you remember in the episode, he was explaining that this is most certainly a special grade. Now, it's important to mention that Gojo is by no means emotional or a kind of guy that succumbs to his anger. But in this scene, he got a little bit angry and threatened to kill all the higher ups. Like, wait a second, does Gojo possess that amount of power to eradicate an entire institution? As I mentioned before, guys, there could be characters who are stronger than him, but I'm not sure. Like, we have to see and wait. I'm really trying not to read the manga. I want to read it so bad, but I know I'm gonna betray myself anyway. One more thing I wanted to add is Gojo displayed some kind of energy-based attack when he was showing Itadori that the finger is actually indestructible. Probably the same energy-based attack was used to punch Sukuna Ryumon like when the fight happened. So this is actually was my first video on Jujutsu Kaisen. I chose Gojo to be my first theory because I wanted it to be something interesting. I think this anime will have like 24 episodes. Maybe I'll do Sukuna Ryumon next. So tell me guys, what do you think about Gojo? What do you think about this theory? Share your thoughts with me in the comment section. Please subscribe. Give this video a like if you enjoyed. This has been a blast art, and I will be seeing you in the next video. Have a great day.